Okay. So I'm Preeti Vadwani. I work at CovTomorrow. It's an Australian healthcare startup, and we are basically into building healthcare apps for people and impacting their life in positive ways. And we have been talking about React Native, Flutter, native scripts. So I'm here to talk about testing in React Native. So do you want to learn it? Are you excited? Yes? No? Okay, so how many of you write tests? Raise your hands. And why do you think that testing is important? Anyone? Like, why? What? Client? Okay, so I also have my views on it, but before I tell you that, I'm gonna tell you like a story, okay? So when I started working with React Native project, I started small. So I started writing the UI components in the projects, and there was a component like blank card, which will like, if you pass anything to it, it will render into a very nice card view. Inside a very nice card view. So what I had to do is I wanted to write a test for it so that no one should mess up with the style of the card view. So the easiest way which I could start to write a UI test in React Native was snapshot testing. So snapshot testing basically like if you write a snapshot test, I'll show you in a while, but when you have a snapshot test and when you run it, if the snapshots are not there, they'll get generated, and if they are already there, then it will compare with the old snapshots. If they are the same, then the test will pass. If something has changed, then the test will fail, and then you have to see and like what has changed and if it was a required change or not. So for I wrote a test for the card view. So, blank card, sorry. So, you have to import the renderer and then you basically pass the blank card to the renderer and create the snapshot. And when you do yarn test, it will generate something like this, which you can like understand. You have to look into it and see like what exactly is happening. I passed a text to it and it's just rendering inside the card view. And it gets saved. So tomorrow, if anyone will make any changes to my blank card, it will fail, and I'll see that if the change is fine, like yeah, it's the style, we had to change the style. I can just run a yarn test -u to update my snapshots. Otherwise, I'll tell the person that please don't mess up with my styles. Okay. So that was about snapshot testing. This is like one of the nice command I came across. Like suppose you're working, so and you want that anytime you make any change, your test should run for that particular code. So you can just do yarn test -- watch, and then it will run in an interactive mode where whenever you make any change in the code, the test related to that code will run. And it gives you an options of running all the codes, like all the tests at the same time. Even like you can update the snapshots by like just pressing A to run all the tests -U to update the snapshot. So it was really useful for us. And like we saw that writing snapshot was really easy. So what I did, like I started writing snapshot tests for all the components. But over time, I realized few things, and I want to share with you like my learnings about snapshot testing. So what I realized is it's important to have short tests about like for the smaller components, rather than having like if your component is too big and if you're writing a snapshot test for it, it will generate a really big file, which will be really difficult to go through and understand. So it's if you have a small component, then writing a snapshot test will be really good thing. And also you need to have a good review culture. Like I told you that you can update snapshots like just like adding minus u and it will get updated. But suppose you your tests are failing and no one is reviewing in the PR that what has changed in the snapshot, and they are just doing that yarn test minus u, they'll just test will pass, and then even if the it was not intentional, it will get merged. So it's really important that you decide a good code review culture in your company, that whenever there are snapshots, have a look into them and see that it was like whether we want to update the tests or not. And describe the test with meaning. Like, this is really so important because your test ultimately become documentation for people like who are going to just look into your code. So if you have written what exactly this test is going to do properly, like just describe it properly, then other people are going to understand like why it is there, like what is the use of it. So moving on, after writing UI, I went ahead and I started writing bigger screens and more logic. So there was this one screen we had, my strategy, it's from an app which was basically tell you task if based on your sleep, like if you're not sleeping properly, it will show you the task list, what you have to do to improve your sleep. And then if this avatar you see, it's a nurse which like just shows the random messages based on your progress. Like if you have completed all tasks, it will say, yeah, well done. And if you haven't completed, it will motivate you to do that. So my job was to write a method which will generate that random message based on different conditions. So, and we encourage and we follow TDD in our company. So what we try to do is we try to write test first with the expected output, and then we write the logic. So I did the same, like I started writing a test. I wrote a test that which is going to fail because there's no logic there. So I wrote that what it should do. Then what is the expected behavior, what I'm gonna get from the method get nurse message, and I was doing the assertion. So after that, my next had to decide that where should I write this get nurse message. I could either write it in my strategy screen and call it there itself, but my strategy screen was already very big, and I realized that if I'll put it there, when I'm testing my strategy, I might have to mock that method. It's better to take it out and, you know, run it in isolation. So what I did, I took it out in a util class and then I wrote the method. So because I had tests in my application, and this has happened many times whenever I want to write a unit test, I could, you know, break down the bigger problem into smaller things, because I had to write methods which are testable, small methods, because if I start writing a big method, it will become difficult for me also to write the test for it. So writing unit tests helps there a lot, and also better architecture. So I'll tell you that whenever I wanted to write a test, I have, if I'm not able to do anything, I try to figure out that what will be the good architecture. Like sometimes in Android, you have to follow MVP pattern to be able to write unit tests properly. So because you want to write test, you will go in that direction, that you will try to find ways of how you can code better. So this was like my experience, and that makes you productive developer, like if you are writing tests. So the test which I wrote finally was like this. So all I had to do is, after writing the method, I had to pass the proper props to it, and that was done. And while writing unit test, many times I faced problems like how do you mock things. So there are if you go around, there are mocking libraries, and if you learn about how to mock functions in Jest, so it is really easy. Like here, I've had to mock a random number generator method. What I did is I used the jest.mock method, and I passed a method name which I wanted to mock. So if you feel that writing unit test is difficult, like it's not that difficult. You just have to find the right resources, and then you can do pretty much everything in that. After learning about unit test, we wrote a few tests, all of us, and then it was time to release the app. But if you want to release the app, we have to test the end-to-end flows, right, properly. And being into healthcare, it was really difficult for us to, because in healthcare, you have to collect data. Like, you have forms, you have to collect data first, and then based on that data, you show the task or whatever you want to do. So, just imagine manually testing all different scenarios. And every time something is changing, again, you have to, test everything. So, what we decided, we'll write an E2E test for those things, like the scenarios which are really important. And there was Detox. We went with Detox. It's an end-to-end testing framework. For React, you can write your test for React Native. And we wrote mostly the E2E test for iOS. It's also available on Android side. When we had tried, we were not able to run it properly on Android, but I think recently they have added more support to it. Sorry. And after that, we decided what are the critical flows in our app with our product manager, and then we wrote E2E test for this, because writing E2E test is time consuming. When they run, it's really time consuming. So it was really important to decide. In Detox, basically you can write tests using Mocha, Jest, and Cucumber. And we wanted to write using Cucumber because we were already using it for different projects. And also, when I show you the test, you'll also understand that why it is helpful. So if you go to the documentation of Detox, there is already, they have mentioned how you can, take care of the test with Mocha and Jest, and we couldn't find how to set up with Cucumber. So we asked it, and you can go to this link and find out how you can do the setup. We went through the documentation, did all the setup. You can follow the link here. The directory structure was like this. We had an E2E folder, and there was a feature folder. Inside that, we had a feature file. Basically, that's the test file. There's some common steps to run the test. And hooks was to just set up the detox. So, if you go through the detox getting started guide, you'll get all this, how you can set it up. And finally, let's write, see some tests, some E2E tests, So, I'm going to take an example of onboarding, because so that we can understand it better. So we had this onboarding component, and when you want to access anything from a component, you first have to give the test ID to it. Okay, so you give a test ID so that you can access it when you're writing the test. After that, we wrote a feature file. Okay, so we decide, you write that, what is the feature about, onboarding feature, and then this test ID basically is used to when you want to run the test. So you give this to Detox that please run this test for me. So this is that one. And then you write the scenario. So this is in Cucumber, so that's where the test, if you write it in Jest and Mocha, it will be different. So you write the scenario that I should be able to click the next button. And in Cucumber, going through Cucumber is out of scope of this talk, but I'll try to cover few basic things which are here. So given and when, then there are a few keywords in Cucumber which helps you write the test and has some meaning. Given, when you want to set an initial context, you say that I'm shown an onboarding screen. And if you want to continue that, you add and keyword and then continue with that, and I can see the agreement model screen. Then you want to perform some action, you say that when I press the next button on onboarding screen, and then what should happen is you write it, and I should be shown the welcome screen. So this is the test. And these statements, we had to, you have to write it and like you have to write that was like just for like if you can read it and understand it. Even if you sit with your product manager, they can sit and understand that. But inside, like you have to write the method of how it will work. So that given thing which I showed, that I'm shown the screen. So here you basically pass the ID which we gave, like the onboarding is the ID of the screen. So I'm shown the onboarding screen. It will go and try to find the onboarding screen, like, and we are using the wait for at index and to exit. These are like methods by detox. So you can use these, like I'm waiting for this element to come at index 0, and like for some time we are waiting. After that, we are expecting that it exists on the screen. So like this, you have to write the description for all the steps, whatever are there. And it's really easy. Like you can write this and make it like a method which you can reuse at multiple places. So this is just a simple example of that. And after that, like after you wrote the test, how you can run it is you first have to add a configuration in your package.json, basically defining that I want an iOS simulator device and I'm doing the debug configuration, and you will specify which phone you want to run this test. So first you have to build the test in detox using detox build command, and you say that this is the configuration I want to build it. And after that, because like if you're not using Cucumber, the running step will be different, but we were using Cucumber, so we had to say that where the Cucumber is, where is our ETV test, and the onboarding minus T is the like which is the test we want to run at onboarding. I told you, like, remember that we're going to use it while running the detox test, and which is the configuration you want to run, and finally it will look like this. So it's basically how we wrote that it should go to the next step, and then I should be shown a welcome screen. So all that steps will happen and test will pass. Like if anything is failing, then we come to know that there is a problem. So writing this test was like, if suppose we didn't have this test, then every time the change is coming, we have to do it. But because we took time to write this once, anytime anything changes, what we did is we made a test suite of tests which are really important, and then every time we have a release, we run that test suite on CircleCR for like maybe 3 hours, and then we know that if those tests are passing, that we make sure that these features are not affected by the change we have done. So now I'll tell you the reason why testing is important for me is, I feel that it helps us to write like documentation. Like you can write, if you write your test properly and if you describe them properly, then anyone who is coming, you can ask them that just have a look into the test. If you don't understand, then we can discuss more about it. And I'm pretty sure that they'll understand that what's going to happen from that. And you can refactor with confidence, because you know that if tests are passing, you're changing anything and tests are passing, that means you're not affected the areas. And it leads to better design and better user experience also, because if the tests are there, then you have the surety and the app which your end user are going to use is going to be crash free and bug free, less bugs at least. So that's it. Thank you for listening to me, and I hope this really motivates you to, you know, write tests and make testing your friend like I have. So if you have any, these are a few useful resources. I forgot to add one. There is like a site called, I'll share it later, but that site has like different problems in different language, and it when you select a problem, they all like have the test in it already described for you. So it helps you build, moving towards TDD. So you can then write the logic and run the test, and if you want, you can add more tests as well. So if you want to improve that, you can, you know, ask me, I'll tell you the site and you can do that. And if you want to reach, if you want to have any questions, you can email me, or I'm very active on Twitter, you can ask me on Twitter and let me know if you want to know anything. I'll be happy to help.
Thanks, Preeti. Any question?